Hey, baby, what you still doing?
Do you know what time it is, Trey?
Here you go with all that.
Yeah, here I go with all that. It's 4 o'clock in the morning, Dre. Where have you been?
I've been where I was at. Now don't start with me, woman. And since you still up so much mouth tonight, why don't you come over here and put it to use?
What the hell did you say? Look, you're disgusting and you're drunk. I'm going to bed.
Don't leave now. Wait up all night for my head so come on.
Stop! Get off me, Dre!
Now look what you made me do. I see why your dad left you and your mom. You black women just don't know how to quit. I'm out.
Sure, that's all it was.
All what was? What I missed? Three got a boogeyman.
You didn't miss anything, nosy. What you need to do is worry about your situation with Mr. Byron. And stop bringing that man along and tell him you ain't trying to marry you.
Okay, how did we end up on me, Miss? I ain't had a man since Color Me Bad.
No, that is not true. Okay, and besides, relationships, sex, it's all overrated anyway.
What did she just say?
Oh, that's your sister.
Overrated. See, what she said. That's how I know. It's official. She's adopted. Because we cannot be from the same gene pool with all that nonsense.
What? Look, I know a lot of women who are perfectly happy without a man.
Name one!
She lied.
Okay. Wait.
Exactly. Not one. That's why it's time for us to find you a real man.
Oh.
Listen, I've been telling her that for years. But it's gonna have to be a plumber or something, because I know her pipes are all clogged up and back. Look.
Much dust. Pipes.
My pipes are just fine.
You even know what
you
are.
Must know. Look, I'm gonna play a little game, and I'm gonna give y'all one night to find this Mr. Right I'm supposed to be missing. And after that, I want y'all to leave me the hell alone. Fair enough.
One night.
Okay. Well, then, ladies and gentlemen. Let the matchmaking begin.
And you better
girl, get it. Hey,
girl, night.
Hey,
girl, night.
You better get it, girl. You better get it. You better be solid. You better figure it out.
Come on, we may not need a girl tonight after all. Hello, Mr. Delivery Man. You're new.
Yeah, it's my first day. I got one package for you ladies.
I would be happy to sign for this, Mr. Delivery Man, if you could tell me your name.
I'm Adam.
You sure are good looking. I think you should meet my good looking friend, Brianna.
Oh.
Brianna, this is Adam. The new delivery app. Isn't he something?
Hi. Oh, yes, you are a very nice looking man. You'll have to forgive her. She's a little...
Ain't nothing wrong going a little cuckoo for some Cocoa Puffs, okay? And in this case, a little mocha caramel. Oh, ain't that right? Charisse, you like some caramel, girl?
B. You like caramel?
And Brie, you like caramel? Yeah, I know you do. So, Adam, isn't Brianna just the most beautiful girl you've ever did see?
She's a beautiful young lady, but unfortunately she would have to be the second.
Oh. And who would be the first?
Well, that would have to be my beautiful wife.
Oh!
Pick up the jaw.
Hell no! I ain't seen no damn ring. He probably wasn't even married. He's probably gay.
Why does he have to be gay?
Yeah, why can't he actually be the one good guy left in this world whose vows actually mean something
and ain't tempted by every short skirt that finds him attractive? Do you see this? Thank you. He's gay. And since he is, our girls' night is back on, so don't even try and get out of it.
Oh my god. I don't know. What? I'm gonna do with you.
You know you love me.
Mm-hmm. I can't.
She ain't got no sense. Anyway, on another note. Listen, how is the search coming for your club?
Oh, God. Still looking, but nothing yet. I mean, every place that I like, I can't afford. But all the places I ate, of course, it's right in line with the budget, but who wants to invest all that time and money into something you hate? So I'm just gonna keep looking and hope something opens up that's both practical and upscale.
Okay. Enough about work. I want to know what y'all gonna wear this weekend.
Ooh.
And Brie, don't even think about showing up like that. Okay? Because we trying to catch you a man, girl, not scare him away.
Girl, look, look at this.
Oh, no.
Oh,
you.
Okay.
Look.
What is you? Oh, yeah. I know you feel it.
What? Ain't that what I'm supposed to be doing to catch this man? I'm supposed to
No.
No.
Never,
definitely not. And if I see you doing that, the only thing you gonna catch is a bad hand.
See? Why you gotta be so violent?
You know what?
I'm going to get me a coffee.
Put the head on.
Girl, give me one too.
You need to get something.
Get something. Oh, and by the way, Ellen is perfectly happy without a man.
Ellen, really, Brie? Ellen.
Bye.
What is wrong with her?
That's your friend.
That is your sister.
That is your friend.
Your blood.
That's yet to be determined. We haven't got protection. How I'm making my pay.
Numbers coming out my pocket for the games that I play. Girl, it looks like it's already jumping in here. It's time to go shake something.
Sweetheart. very bad.
And the other one couldn't dance, but girl, there's got to be some lozenges in here. Just give it a chance.
Loosen up.
Yeah.
I'm going home.
No!
Wait, yes. Bree, wait. We gotta dance at least one time before we leave here.
Besides,
you gotta come on.
I see you standing over there. Why don't you come over here? Take your time, no need to fear. I ain't going nowhere.
Oh,
so you're from Jamaica?
Yeah, man. Born and raised. Come out to Arizona from Jamaica.
Okay. So what's your name?
My name is Jasaka. What's your name?
Oh, I'm Rihanna. You know, you're a pretty good dancer.
Walk into the room. My body go boom, boom, boom.
Okay.
You make me wanna dance to the beat. I feel the tingles in my feet. I love the way you move, the way you rub my thighs.
Oh, you are really doing it.
Moving it loose like we're dancing in the streets. Waiting like a drum when you put it on me.
Okay.
Hey, what you doing in here? Oh, I'm sorry, my man. You mind if I steal away for just a minute? We go way back. I just haven't seen you in such a long time.
Baby, don't you stop. I love the way you move, the way you work these hips. You're shaking in these heels and my heart just
I hope I didn't overstep my bounds, but you look like you needed saving.
Is that right?
I guess I could be wrong.
Hey, yo. Yo, my man.
Okay. Thank you.
You're quite welcome, miss.
Brianna.
Well, it was a pleasure to meet you, man. I'm Sean.
Hey, Bree. Where you been? We've been looking for you all over.
You gonna introduce us to your little friend here?
This is my sister, Sharika.
And I'm her overprotective friend, Ramika. Hello.
If I can see your phone for a second.
Oh, hurry, I'm home. You don't have 25
cents? Or his mama.
She made it up. She's going to go home. Okay.
I'm not understanding this.
You're cute.
Don't even start. He was cute. That's right.
Y'all wanted to come to the club, right?
Mm-hmm. Oh, we're having fun, though.
We're having fun.
Already got your favorite with extra vanilla.
Thank you, Missy. You know I love my vanilla.
Oh, you are so bad. How is Jason anyways?
Amazing as usual. He gets tickets to see Jay-Z and Kanye West while I was out there. I don't think he even knows who they are, but he knows I like them. So he got us front row tickets. I thought I was gonna pass out screaming so loud.
I mean, I'm surprised even you know who Kanye West and Jay-Z are. But I mean, it sounds like you had a really nice time.
Ha, ha. It was the best time ever. Anyway, I didn't come here to talk about Jason. So, start talking.
What?
Not what, but who? This one's charming, I keep hearing all about.
Okay, so which one was it?
You know, Romika can't hold a cup of water to spill it. Did he put it down or what?
Monica, shh. No, he did not put anything down. I just met the man on Saturday.
Okay, and it's Wednesday. He's as fine as everyone says he is. And not broke.
Well, fine. He definitely is. But that still doesn't mean I'm just trying to jump into bed with him. I mean, I just don't know if I should call him or not.
You mean I haven't called him yet? Bree, what are you so afraid of?
Look, when I agreed to go out with Sharice and Ramika last weekend, girl, I never actually thought I would actually meet somebody that still has me thinking about him. But he was just so different and delicious.
So call him.
Ugh, I don't know. He just, I mean, he wasn't part of the plan, you know? I don't know.
Bree, you know I love you, and I only want to see you happy. You know, I was never the one to put you into the dating scene if that wasn't what you really wanted. But I would also hate to see you pass on a man who clearly has your attention and who could possibly be the kind of guy you've always deserved just because you didn't plan him. You don't plan love. When it's right, it's right. And from what I hear, he's really hot. So call him. Besides, if you don't, you never make a will.
Yes, I know she would if she could. Anyways, enough about all that. Back to Mr. French Vanilla. Are you trying to get serious with this guy or what?
French Vanilla. I mean, I don't know. He's just so good to me. You think I pay for these nails? It's hard not to think of spending my life with a man like that.
Oh, so are you talking marriage now?
Oh, I mean, not there quite yet, but I've considered it. He knows my birthday's coming up, and he asked about taking me on another expensive trip. But I told him I already had plans.
Oh, you did? Well, tell me the plan. I mean, I might actually go shopping. Who, what, when, where? Because we already know why. It's your birthday. Yeah, yeah, it's your birthday.
Not so fast, Bree. I don't really have other plans. I just told him that so I could surprise him when I go out there. I can't wait to see the look on his face. He's gonna be so excited.
Okay. Now look at Miss I'm in love. Let's see, I was thinking a day at the spa with your girls, dinner at your favorite restaurant. Sounds like Jason's dessert sounds a little bit better, huh?
Guilty as charged.
Hey, Sean. Hi, Sean.
Hello?
Hi, Sean. Yeah, listen, I don't know if you remember me or not, but I met you at the club the other night and you saved me from like this really big Jamaican guy, and then we talked and you met my friends and you gave me your number, so I'm calling it now. And oh, it's Bree, by the way.
Hey, what's up, Bree?
Yeah, I definitely remember you. What I'm having a hard time with is, took you so long to call.
Yeah. No.
Sometimes daring together and preparing for forever. That's what love is. Faithful and responsible. Getting through any obstacle together. Doing the impossible together. That's what love is. That's what love is. You, my body is life. So girl, take care of me,
take care.
And I'll be there for
I'll
you.
Be there.
I could live better be without you.
I never felt this way.
Just keep it real with me.
Keep it real.
Now keep it real with you. I know how it feels to be in love.
And that won't change, cause you're my
being
me.
Being caring, oh. Sometimes there.
See, I like myself, I can only be a positive. You see, mind over matter, I'll never be a negative. Matter of fact, I'll never be flat, I can only stay sharp. You see, I rock real natural. Girl, my swagger's in the signature. I speak in triplets and paradiddles, destroying and riddle the side of your mind. Yet I'm inclined to say I'm fine. Well, you see, we rock real nice. We jazz real fine and headbang against the system. Don't you miss them old school joints that really had a point. I said we rock real nice, we jazz real fine and headbang against the system. Don't you miss them old school joints that really had a point.
Thank you.
Come on. All right, everybody, give it up for Chocolate Peacock. Come on. All right. Now, we have a special guest coming to the stage, my special friend. Give it up for the one and the only, Miss Brianna Braxton.
Can I talk to my ladies tonight?
Yeah.
You see, I know some of you might be going through something right now in a relationship. And sometimes it helps to just get it off your chest. So, can we talk about it tonight? In a crowded room, I stand faceless, waiting for you to notice me. I see you when I call out, but my voice is but a whisper upon deaf ears. You can't see me, hear me. Your eyes are blind to the way I look at you. Your skin numb to the way I caress you. Your heart grows cold to the thought of me and you. My pain deepened by the reality of it all. Too angry to cry and too hurt to ask why, but too far gone to just say goodbye. So I stand alone in the distance, on the outside looking in at what used to be us. Wondering how I became that itch you can't scratch, that flea you can't flick, that Girl, you came to wish would get off your mind. Because you've fallen out of love or lust or whatever it was, and it's over now. You see, I play it back in my head like an old love song. Two people drifting upon one, searching for one, went wrong. The string of melodies never cut so deep. Alone, I toss and turn, fighting the truth in my sleep. I will never taste your sweet kisses. Never make love to you in a bed of roses. Never dance with you like we used to. Never be the girl I wanted to be for you. My heart is weary, but I am strong, ready to move on, ready to embrace the thought of me loving me, ready to be alone. Thank you.
Keep it going, y'all. Miss Brianna Braxton. Come on, guys.
You made it.
Of course I made it. Been waiting for the invitation for like a month. But you know, I wouldn't have missed it for the world. Especially for you.
Well, thank you. And I'm really glad you came.
Me too. Let's get a drink.
Okay, I could go for a white wine.
Excuse me. White wine, Hennessy parody. You know, you're pretty good up there.
You think so, huh?
Absolutely. You spoke with so much passion.
So, you thought I liked passion. And now, I guess there's supposed to be a compliment in there somewhere?
Yes, it is. I don't know what guy was dumb enough to let you get away. But if given half a chance, I'll never leave you.
You know what? Let's get out of here.
Yeah? Let's go.
We spent all night up laying in this bed. Freaky thoughts running through my head. We just made love for an hour. Now we're headed to the shower, baby. Yeah, when we return, we still got that same feeling. My body's dripping already and willing. So many things that I'd love to explore. And then we made love on the floor. I'll take it right here where we are.
Different than any other guy, Bree. God, I'm just so. Ugh.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to wake you.
No, it's fine. I didn't even realize you got up.
Oh, you're just as beautiful when you sleep.
So the whole drooling thing does it for you, huh?
Oh yeah, along with the roaring snore. So sexy.
Okay, but I do not snore.
I'm sorry, did I say snore?
Don't try to change it now.
Oh, I'm serious. Why do you always think I don't mean what I say?
Well, let's just say, in my experience, it's safe to say most men don't.
Well, I'm not the last guy that you've talked to. Well, I'm not most men.
No, you're definitely not Andre, and I didn't mean to imply that you were, but you know what I meant.
So he has a name. Andre, huh? Now, is this the guy that's making it so hard for a guy like me to get close to a girl like you?
What is that supposed to mean?
What it means is you're obviously putting me in the same boat as this Andre character. And judging by the fact that he's no longer here, I can't possibly imagine how that's a good thing for me.
Look, you know Andre, and I'm sorry if that's the way that it came across, but it was a rough time for me. I mean, he would always throw words like love and forever around, and in an instant it was just over. I mean, he took something from me that I can never get back and then just left. So my apologies if I sound just a little bit cynical right now. You know, I'm sorry. Why are we even talking about him?
You know, you're right. You don't deserve any of that. I know that. Can we get back to what's really important right now? What is this?
Oh, I got a little chilly. But that just means you get to take them off.
I think I can handle that.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Good morning, ladies. How's everybody doing?
I'm sorry, but who the hell are you and what have you done with little Miss Grumpy that I sometimes call my little sister?
Charisse, tell me how you really feel. I can't just come in and say good morning.
Hell no, Chick. He finally hit, didn't he? Ooh, let me sit down because I know this is gonna be good.
Would you stop?
Excuse me. You didn't answer the question.
Did. It's about time. So exactly how big are those shoes?
What?
I mean, he must have a really big...
Ramika!
But what?
Yeah, you know what? He's got great big... man feet. But he's just so gentle and caring.
And then he put on that chiropractor hat and broke that back. Girl, you know gentle and caring ain't got you coming in here all chipper like that.
Listen, I know we ride you about your love life. But girl, I'm so excited for you.
I'm happy for you and her.
Oh, it's a package deal.
Listen. Okay. But seriously, tell Mr. Handyman that I'm watching him, so he better take good care of my girl.
Girl, he will. He a good
one. Yeah.
He a good
one. Thank you, boy.
Major, cause I'm making major moves. I'm in the major things that you wish you had to do. And I can see you watching me cause I've been watching you.
Come on, man.
What?
I feel pretty good today, fellas. Y'all might want to get in on this.
Are you serious? Is anyone else seeing this? Come on now, guys. I gotta have more swag than this dude. That's my son.
So what's been going on with you, man? We ain't seen you in a minute.
Oh, man. Between work and my girl, things been kind of crazy.
Your girl? You mean like a shorty, right?
Nah, man. She's not just a shorty, man. I mean like my girl, you feel me?
Well, she's as pretty as me. I can't really blame you, man. I mean, it's a hard job staying this far.
So, does she have any hot single friends or what? Hook me up.
Easy, killer. I don't really think you would know what to do with all that if he did. But for real, she got any hot friends?
Man, if she did, I'm sure they not trying to hit y'all.
Would have to take a number to get at me. I mean, there's only so much of me to go around.
Man, let me show y'all how to do this.
Oh my God, so this is what heaven looks like? Cause I thought I was supposed to see a white light first. I really wasn't ready to go, but this is okay. This is good.
Y'all playing ball today or what? I saw you looking, and you definitely look like a place.
Whoa, cuz. Matter of fact, see up for me. Hey, man. Can't blame me. You do look nice. How'd you know I was here?
You know I have my sources.
I bet you do.
But really, I thought you might want this.
Oh.
Yeah. Don't worry though, everything I got was on sale.
Well, you do know you're worth every penny, right?
I better be. But I'm gonna let you get back to your game. Just don't pull any muscles you might need later.
Game time.
Y'all ready? What game?
We're looking to assign a contractor for the Gateway Project by next week, so send me your final proposal and I'll make sure we get you added to the review with our contract committee. Absolutely, Mr. Borshen. We'll talk to you soon. Yes, Laura?
You have a gentleman here to see you about a new project downtown?
Downtown? I don't show anything on my calendar. Does he have an appointment with someone?
He specifically asked for you, and he says it's regarding an urgent legal matter with his project downtown.
An urgent legal matter? You know what? Let me check. Maybe it's something Ted was working on before he transferred. Go ahead and send him in.
Okay.
Go ahead and have a seat. We're just trying to go through everything we have downtown. Maybe you can refresh me since I can't seem to... find anything, an urgent legal matter downtown. Sean, what are you doing here?
Yes, definitely an urgent matter to address.
Stop.
What? I mean, seeing as how you're always so busy with work, I figured you'd probably use a break.
Sean, this is my office.
I know, and I already locked the door.
Oh, God, you smell so good, too. 5 minutes.
Yeah. I think you do it to your hips. I might only need 3.
Yeah, everything's fine. You know what? It was just a vase.
Give me just a minute. I'll send maintenance right up.
Oh, no, 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 no. It's fine. It's no problem at all. I'm just cleaning it up now.
Are you sure?
Yeah, it's no trouble. You know what? I'm actually almost done.
Oh, let's see. I spent most of my afternoon trying to deflect all of Laura's inquisitive questions. But after that, I actually managed to make a little dent in the stack of projects on my desk right now.
Well, Miss Corporate America, I'm glad that you found the time to pencil me into your busy schedule.
I mean, it pays the bills and all, but I honestly would trade it in a heartbeat for a chance to open my own spot. Artists like me could showcase some of the most creative art forms out there, you know? What's stopping me? Well, let's see. It's not like banks are exactly handing out loans to just anybody.
Last time I checked, you're not just nobody. You're somebody.
You know, she used to have this jar full of money that she kept on the counter. And me and my sister would always try to get her to spend it on whatever the latest thing was. And she would never budge. She wanted to own her own restaurant. She was a waitress for as long as I can remember. And she would always tell us, one day I'm going to be running my own restaurant instead of working at one. I'd be like, Mom, how do you expect to do that when we're barely getting by, struggling to make ends meet? She would look at me and say, $1 at a time, baby. $1 at a time.
Sounds like a smart woman than me. Seems like she just wanted the best for her daughter.
She did.
Go ahead. Very beautiful.
Okay? Just stop.
Stop what? Loving you? You know what? That's not gonna happen.
Well, it needs to. Look, I don't know what you're trying to do here, but I didn't ask for this. Everything's going just fine, and then you pull this.
Pull what? I don't understand you. I thought this would be the part where you say, you know what, Sean? I love you too. And then sparks and fireworks start to fly.
Well, you were wrong. This is not the 4th of July, and I don't love you. So let's just stop, okay? You know what? I can't do this.
Bree.
Goodbye, Bree. Sean.
Bree. Brianna.
Brianna. It's another wonderful day. Sun shining on my face.
Who finally decided to show up?
Look, don't even start with me today.
And I see you brought your attitude with you, too. Charisse is putting a presence over there. And your attitude, you can leave that at the door.
You know what? I'm a...
I love ya. Hey, y'all better not be burning up my meat.
So nice of you to join us, sis.
Hey, Charisse. Nice to see you, too. And yes, I know I'm late, okay? But it was just a rough night. Sean and I got into a little bit of a fight.
What happened? Are you okay? Wait a minute, because I warned him. Am I going to have to go cut him?
Stop. Nobody's cutting anybody. I just don't think we should continue to see each other.
Well, come here, sit down. Sit down. I know he didn't put his hands on you. Is he cheating? Is he cheating on you?
No, no. Nothing like that at all.
Okay, he didn't put his hands on you. Not. He lives at home with his mama, doesn't he?
Stop. No. He told me he loved me.
He used that line. And then what'd he do?
What do you mean, and then what? He said he loved me, Charisse. Look, I'm not trying to go down that road. We were doing fine, hanging out, things were great. And then he pulls that, trying to complicate everything.
You are so lucky you're my sister right now. If not, I would slap the black off you.
Off me?
Yes. This fine man, this fine-ass man, I might add, tells you he loves you and you're acting all dumb? Got me ready to go cut somebody? For what? If anybody should be mad, it should be Sean.
Hey, Bree Bree.
Hey.
I thought I saw you sneak in. I heard Sean's name, so catch me up. How are things going? I need all the details.
Yeah, how are things going?
Things are fine. There are no details, and we don't even need to talk about me. So, how was the latest excursion to Cancun with your man?
One, it's Cancun. And two, look at my face. He is so incredible. I know I look like I got Botox injections. But I guess it's just the power of the... Wait, where the kid's at?
That's what I'm talking about. At least you know what to do with it.
Uh-oh. What I miss? What's going on with Sean?
Yeah, Brie. What's going on with Sean?
Look, Sean is a good guy. I just don't think it's a good idea for us to keep seeing each other, that's all.
What? Why? What happened?
He told me he loved me.
Oh my gosh, congratulations! Wait, but then what happened?
My point exactly. Would you talk some sense into her?
Okay, I'm confused.
There's no confusion. Look, yes, I agreed to try to get out a little more, but love? That was never a part of the plan. And now he's trying to change all the rules? Uh-uh. I just ain't feeling it.
Okay, let me get this straight. This is the same man who had you coming in singing love songs in the mornings, throwing out those frumpy clothes, and showing off your gorgeous body for once, who would surprise you with expensive dinners, who supports you, your poetry. Oh, and who now, by the way, says he loves you. And you ain't feeling it?
You know what? I need a drink with alcohol in it. Slap her upside the head for me.
Look, Monica, you know what I went through with Dre and how things ended. And I don't ever want to go through that again. I can't do it.
I know what you went through, but you cannot keep running. You don't have to be with this man. If you're happy and content being by yourself and paying for your own dinners, then so be it. But I don't think that's the case. And being afraid to step outside of your comfort zone is not a reason to deprive yourself of an opportunity to be happy or to even go to Cancun yourself someday. Listen, I just want to see you happy, and I know this man makes you happy. You can't just keep running, Brianna. You deserve happiness, but you're never going to find it if you keep shutting everyone out.
I'm not shutting him out. I don't know. I'm just not ready for this whole love thing. I just think it's better this way.
Who are you trying to convince? me or yourself. Just think about it.
I'm gonna go make sure Charisse is using the good crystal.
Come on, everybody. It's time to sing happy birthday to Amaya. Come on. Hurry, hurry. Go to that table over there. There you go. Come on. Slow down, slow down. To that table.
Everybody on three. One, two, three.
Double Dutch boogie, do that double Dutch dance. Do that double Dutch boogie, do that double Dutch dance. Do that dance, dance. Do that, do that, do that. Dance, dance, dance. Do that double Dutch boogie, do that double Dutch dance. Do that double Dutch boogie, do that double Dutch dance. Do that dance, dance. Do that, do that, do that. Dance, dance, dance. This beat is hot, this beat is cold, it's got you twisted. Can you feel that beat go? It's so ridiculous. It's in your hands, it's in your feet, it's like it owns ya. We never touching all the way from New York City to California. Don't try to fight it, you invited to this party. Just feel that beat and move your feet, cause we about to do that. Do that double Dutch dance, do that dance, dance. Do that, do that, do that. Dance, dance, dance. Do that double Dutch boogie, do that double Dutch dance. Do that double Dutch boogie, do that double Dutch dance. Do that dance, dance. Do that, do that, do that. Dance, dance, dance.
Oh, yeah.
Thanks for cleaning up, y'all.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Yeah.
You out there trying to dance.
Girl, they had me doing, I was doing.
You was doing something.
Yes, she is. Listen, she would have tried to stay out here the whole night if I would have let her. I cannot believe she is 10 years old.
Oh my gosh.
Time goes by so fast.
I know. I barely see you guys anymore. I feel like I'm going to blink and Amaya's going to graduate from college.
Yeah. It seems like yesterday that I just had her. Straight out of high school. I was so scared. I didn't know what I was going to do. But as soon as I heard that first cry, I knew everything was going to be okay. It's just a shame her dad didn't feel the same way.
Have you talked to him at all?
Nope, not a word. But you know, it's okay. Because according to Amaya, Tony's the only father she has, the only father she knows. And he's perfect for us.
I'm so happy you guys found each other. He really is a good guy, and I adore him. I only hope I'll be so
happy. Yeah, I heard about the trip you're planning with Prince Charming.
Well, I don't want to jinx it, but fingers crossed, ladies. I think you might actually be the one.
The one.
Oh my gosh. Okay. Where have I been? The one? Clearly, I've been missing way too many birthday parties.
Yeah. I know, right? When did the weekend getaway come to one?
Girl, start talking.
Now.
Okay. Okay, so I was shopping, right? As usual.
Right.
And I walk in and I see this guy straight out of a GQ magazine. Oh. And guess what else? You would never guess.
He had a black card.
Right. Yeah! Oh my god.
What's wrong? Back to your friend.
So, Genome Studio or whatever. But, so I'm just, you know, shopping.
Great. Can I talk to you?
Sean, what are you doing here?
I thought since you were not answering any of my calls, why aren't you here?
Well, maybe that's because I have nothing else to say. Now you found me. We talked. So if you'll excuse me.
Wait. Why are you acting like this? This is not you.
Look, I gotta go on right now, but you're more than welcome to stick around.
Give a warm welcome for Miss Brianna.
Might have fun in your life.
Now, where's all my grown and sexy folk at tonight? You know, some of us, we get caught up in all of that emotion and lust sometimes that before we know it, we leap before we look and we're out there on that ledge with no safety nets.
All right.
You see, I made that mistake one time before. And if I had it to do all over again, I might say something like this. From across the room, I see you standing at the bar. Your eyes up and down my thighs. You about to take this here too far. I can see your mind going places no man has ever been before. In and out, and up and down, around and around we go. But not before you hold me from behind, whispering softly how this will all unfold. With heavy breathing and temperatures rising, I think I'm about to explode. With passion, pure joy, the most erotic ecstasy. But just in time, you slow it down.
Well,
you want to take your time with me. You start with warm kisses on my neck, your tongue slowly working down the small of my back. Your hand firmly gripping my womanhood, you pause to say, do you like it like that? I can't move, can't speak, all I can do is moan. You see, thinking about all these pleasures I've denied, I've been waiting for this for so long. Nervous, a little scared, maybe I'm having second thoughts. Then I stop to feel what you're doing to me and suddenly I forgot about all those hesitations and reservations and insecurities. And before I can second guess myself, and up and down, around and round as you call my name. But wait. You see, thinking about how I imagined it all, somehow this just didn't feel the same. I could feel a tear roll down my left cheek as I realized what I've done. That moment, that single moment, if I could have it back, just that single one. When I saw you from across the room with those thoughts running through your mind. As you approached me with all that suave sexiness and gave me your best line, I would smile, be kind, and tell you how flattered I was by your interest. I would extend my hand and say, it's nice to meet you, and walk away. My innocence. That moment, that single moment is now and well. It was nice to meet you.
Woo! We ain't over yet. Give another round of applause.
make your brother want to do at least 3 push-ups to get into shape. Say hello to that. You hear me? All right.
So, is that clear enough for you?
Nothing to talk about, so I would really appreciate it if you would stop calling my phone, okay? Charisse? Look, I'm sorry. I didn't realize it was you. It's nothing. I just thought you were somebody else. I don't even want to talk about it. All right. I love you too, sis. What are you doing here, Sean?
Look, I'm sorry to show up like this, but we need to talk.
There's nothing for us to talk about. You really need to go.
Can't do that, Bree. Please, can we just talk? Thank you.
So, I mean, would you like some coffee or tea or... You know what? Yeah, why don't I put some coffee on?
Look, hey, I don't want any coffee or any tea or any other beverage. I just want you. I just want you.
No. No. I'm not gonna do this. You need to go.
So that's it?
Yeah, that's it. Now please, just go.
No, I'm not gonna go. Look in the mirror. I mean, really look. There's your truth, Bree. Despite what you may think, I'm not your father. I'm not Andre. I'm not every other good man that then came after and never stood a chance because every time they got too close, you find a way to run them off. Bree, I'm here. I'm not going anywhere. Everybody has a story. How long are you going to keep punishing yourself for someone else's mistakes?
Oh, so you think you know me now? You don't know me, or my father, or Andre. You have no idea what they took from me. So you don't know anything about me.
I know you're hurting. I know you've been running for a long time. Every time someone gets close to you, you find a way to shut them out or run them away before they can even leave you. You don't have to run no more, Bree. Not everybody's trying to leave you. You think I can't see through you? Hiding behind appointments isn't going to change the past. You're so good at telling everybody else what to do and how to feel, but you're too damn stubborn to take your own advice.
This is not about me. I'm fine. I just don't love you the way you want me to.
No, you're not fine, Bree. I don't believe that for a second. You know, sometimes you have to cut yourself open and take a good hard look inside to find your own truth, Bree. However scary that might be. And then you'll start to heal. But you can't be afraid to let someone love you. Let me love you. I mean, really love you. Because I'm standing right here and I'm telling you, you're enough. You're enough.
No. No. I'm not. I'm not enough. I've never been the little girl whose mom and dad came to all her dance recitals. And I have never been the girl the captain of the football team wanted to take to the prom. And I've never been the woman Prince Charming wanted to see walking down the aisle to become his wife. I have never been enough. And I hate him for it. I hate him.
Said last night, and after some thinking, I realize I love you too much to cause you any more pain. I will respect your request and give you the space and time you need, and hopefully find some resolution and heal your wounds. If I could take the pain away myself, believe me, I would, but I know now that I can't. If it's meant for us to find our way back to each other, then I have to believe that one day your heart will be ready and we will. I mean every word I said last night. I love you, Brianna Burst. Sean. P.S. Follow your dream. I believe in you, so let me be the first to invest. $1 at a time, right?
Cause it's an ongoing battle between love and your dreams, struggling and fighting between you and me. Would our love be unbreakable if your name was already shining light? So I'm letting you go.
here. I'm gonna get you. I gotta stop to make it before I take you to your mom.
I don't need no pity button from a few of my favorite things. I don't need all the stress and I don't need no greed button from a few of my favorite things. I don't need a million clothes and all your watches and rings button from a few of my favorite things. All I need is to eat cause I'm down for my team. Believe me, from a few of my favorite things. All I need is a piece of mind.
Maya, what do you think?
Think about what?
About this place. This club I've been trying to open forever. Girl, I know it doesn't look like much, but I'm about to have a grand opening.
Shit, you mean I was gonna be there?
Something tells me they're probably gonna be busy that night, but I will make sure they get an invitation, okay? One day, Amaya. One day.
Inside, my heart is crying. Inside,
sometimes,
don't know why I'm even trying. Can't seem to get you out of my system. Not asking too much, just take some time to listen. We've had our ups and downs, can't seem to turn them around. But if we pray together, we can stay together and live happily ever after. Yeah. What happened to this laughter? Yeah. So please stop. I know.
Hi. I'm looking for Andre.
What is your name?
No, I'm actually an old friend of his, and I have something of his I thought maybe you should have. Is there any way I could see him for a second?
Hello, Andre. Got somebody here to see you. He'll be with you in just a second.
Thank you.
Food's all set, you go ahead and put it on the front.
Well, today must be my lucky day. Girl, you look amazing. Looks great. I know in the past things were kind of bad between us. It probably was my fault. But I'm glad you're here now. Maybe we can try round two.
Wow. Round two, huh?
Yeah, man, you know how we used to do.
Now, exactly what would your pregnant girlfriend think about that? Yeah. The streets still talk, Andre. You know, I used to think I was so angry the next time I saw you. But I'm really not. Because I realized I actually forgive you for that night.
Marie, what is this about? I gotta get back to work.
I used to hate myself wondering if I had told you right away, things might have been just a little bit different. But seeing you now, I really don't know if it would have changed anything. Good luck with your baby, Andre. Don't make the same mistake twice.
Can I help you?
You know what? Actually, I'm sorry. I think I may have the wrong house. I'm gonna just go. I'm sorry to disturb you, sir.
Brianna? You know you always did have your mother's eyes. Come inside. I know you've got a lot of questions. Have a seat. Can I get you something to drink?
No, I'm fine, really. I really can't stay long.
Brianna, I understand. I don't want to keep you. You know, I've prayed for this moment for so long. I just can't believe that it's really you. I know you probably don't believe that, and I certainly don't blame you, but it's true. I love you, Aunt Charisse, more than you will ever know. And I've thought about you every day since the last time that I set you on my knee.
So, then how could you just leave us like that? How could you hurt Mom like that? You know, when she got sick, you didn't come to see her once. You left it to Grandma to take care of us and do what you were too selfish to do. You weren't perfect, but you were our father. And I lost something that day that you left. We all did. I don't remember everything, but I know Charisse does. And she's been so angry with you for so long, and with good reason, because so am I. I just don't understand how you could do that to us.
I know I deserve every bit of hurt and anger you have inside. And there's no excuse for the man I used to be and the father I never was for you and your sister. But I want you to know, baby girl, it was never because I didn't love you girls. You see, alcohol can take a man's soul, if you let it, which I did. Your mom spent most of her days, trying to save me. And it kills me to know I wasn't there for her when she got sick. She was a special woman, cut from a different cloth. And she deserved better than what I could ever give her. And I know she would have wanted better for you girls. It took me a long time to figure this thing out. And I've lost a lot along the way. And the day I heard about your mom is the day I realized it was time to make a change. Next month will be 15 years of sobriety. And I know I owe that to your mom and you girls.
So why haven't you tried to find us?
I got something to show you. I've rehearsed it 1,000 times, what I would say to you girls when I saw you again. But I just knew that after all I put you guys through, I really didn't deserve that moment.
You were there. You were at my graduation.
I was so very proud of you, and your sister too. I was afraid that I would only mess things up for you guys. And I just never wanted to do anything that would hurt you again. I've been writing to you girls for the last 15 years, but I couldn't bring myself to mail any of them. I want you girls to have one. Say anything. The fact that you're here is more than I could have ever dreamed for. thank you for giving me a chance. I don't expect you to forgive me overnight, but I hope someday you can. Take care too, baby girl.
You know what? One picture doesn't make up for 25 years.
Look, Sharice, I don't expect you to feel differently all of a sudden. But for your sake, I really hope you'll at least read them. It finally gave me the strength to open them out of storage.
her how in the world she planned to do that. And she'll just look at us and say, $1
at a time. Raising yourself while she had to work. Listen, go open that club, go make me and Mom proud. Besides, we need another place to hang out. What better place than somewhere where drinks are on you?
He is fine. Listen, his wife was smart to lock it up on the set of Soul Food and them trailers back there. Mm-hmm. I'm mad at him. That was my show. Yeah.
I'm not saying the man ain't fine, but he's no Denzel. Okay? Looking all sexy like he do.
That's true. Mm-hmm.
Then he starts talking to you in that Training Day voice.
I'm gonna lay you down.
Girl, Denzella have you hypnotized before you know what happened. Thank you.
Well, there are no Denzels to go around. I'll settle for Bubba Gump right now.
Oh, she's tripping.
I don't know about Bubba Gump, okay? But I will say that nowadays, it is hard to find a good man with a total package. So at this point, I think I'm okay with selling for a man who can meet my more important needs.
Girl, even if he's meeting every need in the neighborhood?
Hey, as long as that mortgage need, that car note need, and that you know what need. Ago, not to ask questions I do not want to know the answer to. And hey, same goes for him. I think it works great if you both have the same understanding.
Now, see, you shouldn't have to ever settle for anything less than what you deserve. I know it gets lonely sometimes when you don't have someone, but I know when I hit that dead end road, I find me a good script.
Oh, wow. Oh, Lord. She about to hit us with that good book, y'all.
That's right. I don't know about you, but some of y'all just need a little prayer in your life.
Well, start with me then and pray I get some real soon because some of y'all starting to look real good.
Okay. So maybe I do need that good book after all. Or maybe I should just shut it down and become a nun or something.
Wait a minute. That would be an interesting survey, though.
I mean, since men can only get away with what we allow them to.
Yeah.
Hey, how about we play
a little game of Would You Rather? And everybody has to answer honestly.
Okay.
So, would you rather be with a man you know isn't treating you right? Or would you wait for a good one to come along, no matter how long it takes to find him?
Mm-hmm. You know? Okay, well wait. What if you don't know if you have a good man and you need some time to figure it out?
Now, first of all, every woman knows deep down inside whether she's with a good man or not.
That's true.
I mean, I'm not saying he has to be perfect, but you know if he's a good man to you. Mm-hmm. Okay. I mean, sometimes it's like we choose not to see the things we don't want to see. But that doesn't mean that they're not there, mm-hmm. and that does not make him a better man. So, does your need for a man outweigh your need for a good man? Or would you walk away?
Mm-hmm. Charisse.
Why you gotta start with me?
I mean, everybody has to answer, so we might as well start with you.
Come on.
We'll go around.
Tony is really an amazing guy. I would just think he'd have to do something real crazy to get me to walk away.
Aww. Let me tell you, you're better than me because I would throw some hot grits on his ass.
All right.
And of course I would walk away, but with everything that fits in that U-Haul, you feel me?
Well, I'm not saying I give him third-degree burns or anything, but I would like to think that if I'm not being treated the way I deserve to be treated, the way I know I deserve to be treated, I'd have to walk away.
I'd probably pray for him. She would.
I guess I'm on my own then, because there are just some things I am not willing to live without. I mean, I'm not saying you can do whatever, but a bucket of bonbons can only cure so much. And for the record, okay, women have every right to play by the same rules that men do. Right. Most men just know that we probably wouldn't.
That I'd have to agree with right there. I mean, you gotta let them know that there's plenty of them where they came from. Mm-hmm. And just because you ain't fishing, it's not because you can't. Shoot, I keep me a good pole ready. Baby. Oh, oh,
she would too.
Of course. I think I would stay.
You're better than me, because I just have to walk away. Mm-mm.
I mean, you started this exercise, Missy. What's your answer? Are you staying or going?
Yes. All right. Well, I mean, I wish I could say I would walk away, but it's hard when you find that man that's just so sexy. Mm-hmm. And he's looking at you like, baby, please don't leave. I don't know. I think for me, it just depends on who that guy is for me.
Yeah. So, Miss Brianna, you've been sitting there awfully quiet. By the way, have you spoken to Sean at all?
Yes.
Girl, that was one edible piece of chocolate.
No, I have not. Yeah, because I'm still a little bitter about that one. I mean, he sure looked like he had a strong back.
Is there ever a time when your mind isn't in the gutter?
Whatever. I'm just saying what all y'all heifers are thinking.
I know, but we need to leave Brianna alone. Things didn't turn out the way we had hoped. But listen, I don't think I've seen you as happy as I have in the past few months. And if leaving Sean was motivation to start your own club, then who are we to judge?
Brianna,
are you finally gonna get the club?
I'm so sorry, Brianna. I know I wasn't supposed to say anything.
Girl, you keeping secrets from us?
Look, slow down. There is nothing in writing yet.
Really?
What? Yes, things are looking perfect. Hey! Thanks to a little help, I think I have everything I need to get that final loan approved.
This definitely calls for a toast. Yes. Okay. Who needs a man when you buy and build?
Who needs a man?
Who needs a man? I thought I was singing a solo on that note. Girl, what's going on with you and Jensen? How was your trip?
I flew out there last weekend
thinking I would surprise him with a romantic weekend, just the two of us. Well, he was surprised, right along with his wife.
His what?
I walked in and heard noises coming from the bedroom. So I'm thinking I'm about to bust in with some bimbo from work or something, right? It was quite the opposite. There I was looking like the bimbo he flies in for a quick fling from time to time. in front of his wife.
Oh,
not the fiance, not the girlfriend, not the bimbo from work, the wife. Mm-hmm. Oh my gosh. I couldn't even believe it.
Oh my gosh.
I think I just went numb. This sick bastard had the nerve to give me the key to her rental property.
Ooh.
Yeah. Turns out she's worth more than him, so I guess he just needed someone to stroke his inferior ego.
Oh my gosh. Mm-hmm. I'm so sorry.
Needless to say, there's no more Jason.
Wow, Monica, I am so sorry.
Mm-hmm. Oh, me too. I know how much you liked him.
I did. But I don't want to be all doom and gloom, especially after hearing about Brianna, so I'm good. Really.
See, that just goes to show you, a good man is a good man on the inside, no matter what color he is. So when you find one, you'd be a fool to let him go. That's why I gotta take the ring Byron gave me from this finger right here and put it on this finger. Oh my God!
Cold?
Yes, it's cold.
Okay, thanks.
I don't know why I'm friends with her.
Now, are you sure you're up for this? Because after last night and hearing about everything that happened, I completely understand if you don't feel like doing this right now.
Stop, don't be silly. I'm totally up for this. I'll admit, it's been a rough week. I never expected in a million years that Jason would hurt me this way. But after listening to everyone last night, I realized I really need to check myself.
Check yourself? He's the one with the problem.
No, I know, but I think there was a part of me that was never really convinced that he was the man I thought he was.
Mm.
And I think that's why I decided to go out there without telling him I was coming first.
Mm.
I just wanted to believe it was my own insecurities and not really anything that had to do with him. But like they say, if it looks like a duck and sounds like a duck.
Quack, quack, right?
Yeah, quack, quack.
Well, remember what we said. We're here for you. But you're gonna be just fine. He didn't deserve you anyway.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
I really appreciate it. I'm so grateful I have such awesome friends. But anyway, enough about my woes. We have a wedding to plan in.
Ah!
Have you said yes?
I know, right? It's amazing.
So why now? I mean, Byron's been after you for a long time.
Just...
What made you change your mind?
I mean, just that. Byron has been chasing me for so long. I feel like any man with that kind of stamina, with me, is definitely a man worth marrying. But honestly, I have to say I was just afraid that at some point when I finally said yes, all that love and energy that was coming my way would just fade away.
How do you know it won't?
That's just it, I don't. But that's the beauty of falling in love and entrusting your heart to someone else. I mean, if it were something that were easy, I guess love wouldn't be worth holding on to.
I guess you're right. And you guys are gonna be so great together.
I know.
Okay, so...
Thanks for letting us come by before you guys open.
Oh, you know you guys are welcome any time of the day.
Well, thank you.
Absolutely. Now, while you're waiting, do you want something to eat?
Did he really just ask us that? That was a rhetorical question, right?
Yeah, hell. Let me go ahead and get Cheyenne for you, okay?
Okay, thank you.
Thanks. I really appreciate you taking time out from your busy schedule with work and finalizing things at the club and all to come and check out some of the stuff I planned for Rumika. I love her to death, but you know how difficult she is to lose.
Who you thought?
Hi, ladies. Are you guys ready to order?
Hey. Yes, I already know what I want. I'm gonna have the catfish nuggets with seasoned fries and a side of mac and cheese.
Okay. And for you? I'll do the grilled salmon with rice pilaf, but instead of potatoes, can I get like a summer squash?
No, we actually don't serve summer squash.
Okay, I'll do corn on the cob.
You got it? Anything to drink for you ladies? I'll just have water.
Yeah, I'll just have water too. Easy on the ice. Anyway, so the theme. She really doesn't have one, and if I leave it up to her, she'll be trying to get married on the soul train or something, so I really need your help. I was thinking something elegant with an enchanted feel to it.
Wow.
Yeah.
Enchanted.
Yeah.
That would be different, especially for somebody like Romeo. But, I mean, you could do a lot with this place for the reception. You know? I like it. I
just hope I can convince her. You know, as tough as she tries to be, I know she really loves Byron, and I just really want to get it right. They really deserve it.
Yes. Yes, they do. And what about you?
Me?
You know, you deserve a little happiness in your life, too. Are you sure you're going to be all right doing all of this? After everything that just happened?
I know, and Rumika already asked me about it, and I'm perfectly fine, honestly. Actually, I took your advice, and I've been doing a little bit of writing.
Is that right?
Yeah. I wrote a poem, and I was thinking I might perform it the next time I go to open mic night.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Oh my god, that would be awesome. You should do it.
I don't know, I'm just nervous.
So just practice. You know what? Let me hear it now.
You mean right now?
Yeah, right now.
No, I don't know if I even, like, remember.
Yes. I mean, we are the only ones here. You have the whole stage to yourself. This is the perfect time to practice.
I can't believe you're talking me into this. At the end of the rainbow, I found the treasures that would make me worthy. Pearl eyes, ruby lips, and ivory teeth. With diamond-cut abs and pockets brimming with emeralds. I love you dripped from his lapel like blank business cards. I took a Dolce brush and a Gabbana roller and dipped them in a Versace tray filled to the brim with hues of Ralph Lauren. I demanded he spatter it with Dior, Givenchy, and Balenciaga. I ripped the rainbow from the sky, threw it around my neck, and paraded tall and proud over everything and everyone. But most importantly, I paraded over everything about me that wasn't good enough. I centered the deadly stiletto heel of a Lorenzi pump over my precious stone and smashed it, and then drowned the pieces in a bucket of high-gloss Chanel. I called out the wrong name, God. I couldn't see. I was painted.
Wow! Monica! Wow! That was really good. Okay, you are definitely coming with me next week.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Thanks, Bri.
Oh, wow.
You know, it really did feel good to say it out loud.
You know, I mean, look, I know it's probably hard right now, but you really do deserve the same kind of happiness that Ramika found. And I know you're going to find it. You just gotta believe it. You know, I actually been working on a new piece myself that I literally just finished this morning.
Really?
Yeah, and I don't know. I mean, maybe there's something in there that might actually help you out.
Let's hear it. Your turn now.
Okay, yes, my turn now. Let's see.
If I threw a penny in a well, or wished upon a star, would that be enough to realize my dreams, to take me as far as I want to go in life? These good luck rituals sure to bring good fortune, but I'm barely getting by, so I'm starting to think they're not working. So what if I take a different approach and not leave my fate to chance? Take matters into my own hands. I will lead this dance. This dance called life that doesn't always deal us a fair hand. But speak it aloud and it shall be done. Believe it and know that you can. So I'm a doctor now, with sturdy hands, my long white coat and my drawstring pants. A tough road traveled, but I made it through. It's amazing what a little hard work will do. I'm an athlete, performing at the highest level of play. A professional in this sport I love. Wow, I've come a long way. All the practice, all the sweat, all the ups and downs that crossed my path just weren't enough to shake my belief that I could excel in my chosen craft. I'm backstage. The crowd is roaring, anticipating my entrance, anxiously waiting to hear my good work. It didn't just happen in an instant. I remember the day I put pen to paper, thinking, one day this will take me far. I believed it then, when others doubted my chances. That day I became a self-proclaimed star. I'm nervous. It's my first flight. But there's no simulation involved this time. Who would have thought when my folks said reach for the moon that somehow I would find my way through all the training, all the books, all the long hours in that suit to bring me to this very moment, worth every headache, every second it took. So many times along the way, I could have stumbled and fell. I could have said it's too hard and no one would have faulted me. I could have had a different story to tell. But I stood fast on my own two feet, not worried about what others thought was best for me. Because while they were busy trying to take the reins in my life, they were missing their own opportunity. So whether a doctor, an athlete, an entertainer or an astronaut, keep the faith and invest in yourself. Don't wait for someone to tell you who you are and what you're worth. You be your own self-proclaimed success.
That was so amazing.
That was a great job.
Thank you.
Can I get you ladies anything else?
No, thank you.
This looks
enjoy.
So delicious.
Oh, they forgot the corn in the cup, but.
Oh. That was amazing.
Yeah.
Yes. But I can't help but wonder if that was really for me or for you.
You know what, Monica? Honestly, I think we could probably both take a few notes from that one.
True. Well, I don't know about you, but I'll be taking those notes after I dig into this delicious food.
Good. This looks really good.
Hey y'all, sorry I'm late. I know y'all didn't plan the entire trip without me already.
As usual, yes, you're late. However, we did plan the trip. So, ladies, Nashville, Tennessee, let's party!
Don't play.
What, Bree? I think a little do-si-do and a hayride is just what I need before I jump the broom.
Hey, you know I've always wanted to ride one of those mechanical bull thingies. Yeah!
Okay, first of all, don't ever do that again. Secondly, Nashville is a very beautiful city, and I would recommend anybody take a visit at least once in their lifetime. However, it will not be for my girl's bachelorette party. So, where are we really going?
Okay, who left Miss Cloudy with a chance of showers in anyway? Just raining on our little parade.
Yeah. Okay, seriously. There's always Vegas. I mean, you can get in a lot of trouble there.
Mm-hmm. Not that I plan to. Mm-hmm. I'm just looking out for y'all.
Yeah,
girl,
Vegas.
Please, you know, as soon as you pull out $1, Tony's gonna send the CIA, the FBI, the SWAT, and every other acronym to cut your little party short.
Whatever. I'm grown.
Okay, Miss Grown. My couch ain't that soft, so you better hope your sister loves you enough to let you stay in one of her guest quarters in her little mini mansion.
Oh my God, can we please focus? I'm trying to eat. So let's decide where we going so we can beat this Friday night rush.
I mean, Rameka, this is your bachelorette party.
Yes, it
so
is.
So just tell us what you have in mind and we'll take care of the rest.
I know this is going to sound a little strange to you, but I just really am not comfortable with some strange man gyrating in front of me. Mm-hmm. Right before I'm about to marry my best friend and the man I'm going to spend the rest of my life with and the only one I want to get lap dances from. Oh. But it just seems like a strange way to start off a marriage. Mm-hmm. You know? 20 years? Bring on Magic Mike! No. Seriously, I was thinking we could have a nice little vacation getaway to Napa Valley. We could do a little sightseeing by day, a little wine tasting by night. I know it's not the lights and the booty shaking, but what do you think?
Oh my God, personally, I think someone is finally ready to be the wife. Any man would be lucky to have.
It's taken a few years, but I finally rubbed off on her. Napa Valley, here we come!
Okay, hold on. I'm gonna need somebody to monitor her wine intake. Y'all know how she do.
Girl, I got her. Come on, y'all. It's time to eat. Let's go. Napa it is.
Girl, where were you?
I had to work.
We all gotta work.
This world is a crazy place. People around me feel like empty space. No one to see my pain. Hiding behind so many walls of shame.
Are you ready for this? Are you ready for your big night?
Oh, girl, I'm about as ready as I was ready.
If I have not told you, I am so proud of you. But before you go out there, so what's the worst to say?
Thank you.
got the invitation. There's no way I would have missed this. You've grown into such a beautiful young woman. I know your mom is still bragging about you right now. Go get him, baby girl. Okay, Brie?
I could not be better. Let's go make dreams come true.
He said be ready at 7, girl. Cause you know he gon' rock your world. So go on, get your best heels, go on, brush up on your skills, cause you know what's going down tonight. Don't wanna be late, girl. Feeling like the first date, girl. So go on, show 'em how you twerk, got you putting in work. Get ready for the time of your life. The time of your life. Get ready for the time of your life.
The loader, below. Put your hands together, y'all.
Love is a game that she plays. Most heinous the way sin meant to their grave. Intentionally, she intended to be delivered to me most deliberately. Figured that she prayed to Venus, but she.
I, that sure is, Mr. Postman. Come on, come on. That sure is, Mr. Postman.
Might have a bigger rap, but they ain't hungry like me. Many more will come next, but they won't bust it like me. Won't let a thing stop the faith that exists in me. What I'm saying is that, what I'm saying is that. Yeah, yeah. Shout out Brianna.
Yeah. Talk to me, I believe you. Longer nights, special need to please you, cling to you, make me treat you. You help me to meet your needs. Ooh, emotionally, I can see eternity with you. Soul it is, and that's the reason why you got me falling.
This will be my second home ever, so I hope you enjoy it. It takes two to play tug of war. He slipped up, but I pulled one too. If I had prioritized authenticity, this probably wouldn't have happened to me. I still love mirrors, so don't get crazy. But in them, I now see my own soul is more than fashionable. In it, comfort beyond financial. I'm genuine. I'm enough. I'm me again. Thanks.
Okay, guys, the reason that we're here tonight, this person, magic on the mic, a genius with a pen, please give a warm, spirited welcome for Miss Brianna Braxton.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. I want to thank everybody for coming out to Brianna's tonight. Now, this has been a long time coming. You see, I used to think I knew myself better than anyone. But when you've been running for so long, you find out that maybe you never really knew yourself at all. You see, this world is so full of pain and addiction. And not just the obvious ones like drugs and alcohol, but the addiction to self-hatred and self-destruction. The kind of addiction to pain that shows up in the many questionable choices we make in our everyday lives. Sometimes those are the hardest ones to overcome. But thanks to a very special person in my life who loved me enough to show me myself, I can stand on my own two feet firmly, grounded by my own truth, and know that I am and have always been enough. Can I talk about it tonight?
Girl, yeah, come on. Take your
time. I hope you guys enjoy this.
All right.
I keep saying I don't need it anymore. That I'm gonna get myself clean. That this is the last time I will fall victim to my addiction. I say it with conviction. I'm not going to be the fiend. The addict that is so miserable, it's pitiful that she could struggle with loving herself. That she would rather self-destruct to get her next fixed instead of taking care of her own health. Is my life really so worthless that I would willingly throw it away? But I know that's what I'm doing every time I sashay your way. Into the arms of those demons, but without question or fear I go. Unable to completely commit to the only one I truly owe. The only one that can offer me salvation from myself. The only one that loves me enough to show me my own selfishness. That self-pity I carry around just cause I done been through some mess. That ungratefulness, that forgetfulness of how much I am truly, truly blessed. Oh, if only I was strong enough to walk in the same faith that I believe. I could see all the many blessings waiting to be bestowed upon me if I could just open my heart to receive. I dream of a life with that peace of mind. A life free from my own chains. A life free of fear of all things binding. A life free of this addiction to pain. So with these broken chains and my newfound spirit free, claim this to be that life-changing day. I resolve to loving me. Thank you, y'all.
I see myself, I see lights, camera, action, y'all. I see myself, not afraid, I feel 10 feet tall. I see myself, I don't know why it took so long. Don't know what you see, I'm not broken now. Being strong, see myself out your shadow, it's a brand new me. I'm on my way, it's a better day and I like what I see. It's time to shout, time to dance, watch me do my thing. Put your hands together, everybody, help me sing.
Step aside real quick. Yeah, he blocked the light. I'm just coming up on mad bloopers.
You know.
All this bad she's pulling in my ear.
Actually, that was a big
deal. And now, it's now.
But if you stand strong, you will see the reflection. You will see the reflection.
Ha 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 ha!